गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर हैविंग अ गुड डे। सो टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विथ आर न्यू चैप्टर विच इज़ चैप्टर 4। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज़ कीबोर्ड स्पेशल कीज। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट ऑल द कीज ऑन द कीबोर्ड एंड देयर फंक्शंस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ इट। एज यू हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न that a keyboard is an input device and its use to type keyboard has many keys which are used to type words, numbers, and therefore it is used to give input to the computer. If you have seen a keyboard before, then do you know how many keys does a keyboard has? A normal keyboard usually has 104 keys, and apart from the alphabet and numerical keys, it has many special keys. You have read about some of the keys earlier. For example, the delete key, enter key, and space bar. But now let us learn more about the keyboard. First thing that we will discuss about the keyboard are the alphabet keys. These keys have the letters A to Z written on them that help us in typing words. There are 26 such keys, as we only have 26 alphabets in English language. You can type words and sentence using these keys. The first six letters in the top row for the word QWERTY, so it is also called a QWERTY keyboard. You can see the keyboard on the screen for better understanding. You can clearly see the 26 alphabet key on the keyboard, which starts with QWERTY at its first six letters. Now we move on to the numerical key and numlock key. Numerical keys have the number 0 to 9 written on them. They are 10 in numbers. These are found in two places above the alphabet key and on the right side of the keyboard. The number keys on the right are called as the numerical keypad. To use the numerical keypad, the numlock key should be on always. To know whether the numlock key is on, you can see a right above the numerical keypad. As we have learned about the alphabet keys and the numerical keys in detail, we will now learn about the special keys. The first special key that we will discuss about is enter key. This key is found in two places. This key is used to take the cursor to the next line. Next is space bar. It is the longest key on the keyboard, and you will find it at the bottom of the keyboard. It is used to add a space between words. Next special key is arrow key. Arrow keys are 4 in number, and they are used to move the cursor left, right, up, and down. They are also called the cursor control keys because they control the position of the cursor. Next key is delete key. It deletes or removes the character on the right of the cursor. It is found in two places of the keyboard. Then we have the backspace key. It deletes a character to the left of the cursor. Let us now see from the picture below that which other special keys are there on the keyboard. So as you can see that we escape key on the uppermost left corner. Then we have keys with special symbols and punctuation keys. Then tap caps lock and shift keys. So we will be discussing about all these keys in detail. So first we have caps lock key. When the caps lock key is on, the letters you type will appear in capitals. You can see a green light above the numerical pad when the caps lock key is on. Now if you press the caps lock key again, the letters you type will appear in small letters. Next is shift key. This key is used along with other keys in the keyboard. You must have seen that some keys have two characters on them. The punctuation marks and special symbols are marked on the upper side of the dual character keys. To type any of these upper side symbol on present on the key, you must press the shift key along with other key. Shift key is also used to type the letters in capitals along with caps lock key. To type the capital letter M, if the cap lock key is off, press shift key with the key which has M on it. Next we have tap key. It is used to move the cursor right by 5 spaces at a time. Last but not least is the escape key. It is found on the top left corner of the keyboard. It is used to cancel or close a menu. For example, if you have clicked on the start button, you can click on the escape key to close the menu. So with this, we have completed our fourth chapter. I hope you all have understood it. So study well. Question and answers and exercises of this chapter will be uploaded on the website. Write the question and answers in your notebook and do the exercises in your textbook itself. Thank you.